problem is all inside your head, she said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically. I'd like to help you in your struggle to be free. There must be 50 ways to leave your lover. She said it's really not my habit to intrude. Furthermore, I hope my meaning won't be lost or misconstrued. But I'll repeat myself at the risk of being crude. There must be 50 ways to leave your lover. 50 ways to leave your lover. You just slip out the back, Jack. Make a new plan, Stan. You don't need to be coy, Roy. Just get yourself free. Or hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just drop off the key, Lee, and get yourself free. Ooh, slip out the back, Jack. Make a new plan, Stan. You don't need to be coy, Roy. You just listen to me. Hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just drop off the key, Lee, and get yourself free. She said, it grieves me so to see you in such pain. I wish there was something I could do to make you smile again. I said, I appreciate that. And would you please explain about the 50 ways? She said, why don't we both just sleep on it tonight? And I believe in the morning you begin to see the light. And then she kissed me. I realized she probably was right. There must be 50 ways to leave your lover. 50 ways to leave your lover. You just slip out the back, Jack. Make a new plan, Stan. You don't need to be coy, Roy. Just get yourself free. Or you hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just drop off the key, Lee. Slip out the back, Jack. Make a new plan, Stan. You don't need to be coy, Roy. You just listen to me. Hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just drop off the key, Lee, and get yourself free.
And today is the 14th day of February in the year 2024, Anno Domini. It's not the den, but it's a den special. And I think, do we need a disclaimer for this one? No, I don't think we need a disclaimer for this one.
Okay.
So normally on my broadcast, about the time when I do a monologue, some people call it a rant. So
I like to call it a rant.
All right, well...
It's a PSA.
Okay, a PSA.
Yeah.
All right. So let's jump right into that, Peter.
The views expressed by the host during this monologue are those solely of his own, not those of Westfield State University, the Radio Club, or Sophia, filling in for Kathy Palmer. And now...
You going to load my background for that?
What background for that? Oh, okay. Stand by.
And thanks for noticing Sophia in here. I was going to get around to that. But it is the Valentine's Day special. She's probably never heard of Luther Vandross either. No, this is Marvin Gaye. This is Marvin Gaye. Ladies and gentlemen, gather around, y'all. It's that time of year again. Love is in the air. Or is it the smell of overpriced roses? Ah, yes, Valentine's Day. The holiday Hallmark built and the candy companies just adore. You know, it's truly heartwarming how we need a designated day to remind us to be nice to our spouses. Because apparently, being loving and caring is too much of a chore the other 364 days of the year. So thank you, Valentine's Day, for keeping our relationships intact with your mandatory displays of affection and obligatory gifts. Well, let's talk about the real MVPs in this holiday. The candy companies.
Okay.
Oh, yes. Oh, how they rejoice in the sweet sound of ka-ching as they sell us heart-shaped boxes filled with sugar-coated guilt. And don't get me started on those poor folks who are single. They're subjected to a relentless barrage of romantic gestures, reminding them of just how alone they are.
Aww.
And oh, the depression, the loneliness. It's like a dark cloud hanging over the heads of the unattached, raining on their parade of self-pity. But fear not, my friends, for there is a silver lining to this cloud.
There is?
The day after Valentine's Day. Yes, February 15th, when the candy aisles transform into the paradise of discounted chocolates and sweets. Who needs love when you can drown your sorrows in half-price candy? Am I right? So in conclusion, let's all raise a glass to Valentine's Day. A holiday built on commercialism, guilt tripping, and a dash of loneliness. But hey, at least we get cheap candy out of it, right?
Sure.
Cheers to that. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got a date with a discounted box of chocolates. Happy Valentine's Day, everyone. Or not. Who really cares?
Isn't Single People's Day next month?
Well, we're not going to get into that.
All right.
All right, so welcome to Ken's Valentine's Day special. I'm sitting here with Sophia, one of the students here in the Arts and Communications Department here at the Tech Academy. We can never replace Kathy Palmer, but she's doing it today.
I'm Kathy Palmer.
Mm-hmm. All right, so what does Valentine's Day mean to you?
Oh, what it means to me? Loving, mm-hmm. caring, like giving stuff to your loved ones,
mm-hmm.
your family. Mm-hmm. Because I love my family and my friends.
Yeah. Giving more than receiving or receiving more than giving?
Both, I guess.
Uh-huh.
I got some flowers and I got like a flower and then a gift card from my mom.
Mm-hmm. All right.
And then I have practice after.
So. Mm-hmm. You have anything to give to her?
I made her a card.
Oh, okay.
From Canva.
Uh-huh.
It says, I like shiny things, but I'll marry you with paper rings.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So you did both giving and receiving already today? All right, that's cool.
Peter, better than we are.
Peter, what does Valentine's Day mean to you?
I don't live with my fiance, right? Because mm-hmm. we're in different states.
Right.
She's in Hartford today, and we're going to try to meet up for dinner somewhere in between here and Hartford. Mm-hmm. We're trying to settle on a location that might have some availability.
Uh-huh.
Village Pizza in Southwick. It's like the border between.
Yeah, okay. We're thinking more like Avon, though, because she's got to go like back to New Hartford.
Oh.
And then I'm going to spend time watching some, going back to her house and just kind of spending time with her, because I don't get to do that all the time. So that's my big Valentine's Day today.
Yeah. We're a lot closer to Village than she is, because I've done that drive with Peter, with Mr. Coles.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. She's a little further down. Yeah.
It's my favorite place to go.
What, Village?
Yeah, I've been going since I was like 9 or 6 years old.
Mm-hmm.
That's cool.
Yeah, I'm close with them. Like, they have my specialty salad over there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You're a Village pizza fanatic?
Oh, yeah.
Well, you know, that's kind of funny she mentions Village, because when I do work during the day down in my office or town hall down in Southwick, I place an order for the grinder of the month to bring home with me every time I'm down there. By the way, this month it's a cheeseburger grinder.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm. Wait, when I work for Joe Didi on Friday, I'll probably end up getting one of those to bring home. Yeah. I wonder if they have a heart-shaped pizza today.
I don't think they do.
No, I'm sure if you ask, they'll make one. No, it's not difficult.
No, I don't really eat out
mm-hmm.
much because that's just me.
Uh-huh. You got to move that mic over a little bit.
Oh. Is that good?
Well, yeah, because you keep drifting off of it.
Oh.
And this is another reason why we have you here. So we learn more about arts and communications. Sophia is one of the students who actually showed up at the air show in the summertime when school wasn't even in to help learn how to operate a camera and use it. And
it was fun.
Yeah.
You know, you should do a hype video for the swim team.
Mm-hmm.
With that camera.
You know, if you write up a script and you put together some type of format, mm-hmm. you will have my support to film something like that with you.
Is the air show next year?
Probably the year after.
Probably the year after. But if you want to create a video for the team, you will have our backing to help you out with that.
Okay.
We have access to GoPro.
Mm-hmm.
That's nice.
All right. Yeah, we have the possibility of underwater gear for that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have states this weekend.
So that's our promise to you. We're not going to make it this weekend, but plan something and we'll put it together. You know, are there any people out there that still say Valentine's Day?
Valentine's.
I remember when I was in school.
With an M?
With an M. Valentine's.
What?
Yeah. When I was in school, all the kids in elementary were calling it Valentine's. And
that's because you didn't know any better?
I guess so. It's just something I remember from like third grade or fourth grade where everyone was being corrected on that.
It all goes back to St. Valentine.
Yeah. Yeah. Which, by the way, if you don't know the story of St. Valentine's, you should Google it. Because it's not what you think it might be.
Is it the one that he like chased out all like the snakes?
No, that's
St. Patrick.
That's St. Patrick. that's another month away.
No, St. Valentine was.
It was a guard. He was a jailer.
But also we talked about it this morning on Wake Up Wednesday, that he was marrying people when the king had outlawed marriage. The king had outlawed marriage, or the pope had outlawed marriage. Not sure which. Oh, you know what it was? It was a Roman emperor that outlawed marriage because he had determined that single men made better soldiers than married men. And so he outlawed marriage, and St. Valentine was secretly marrying people behind the emperor's back
mm-hmm.
and eventually paid with his life for that.
Yep.
And the pope...
So then he became a god?
No.
No, not a god.
Saint.
Oh. Yep.
Then the Pope sainted him after he found out what he did. And according to the Catholic Church, you have to perform at least two miracles that are documented, either during your life or after your life.
Yeah. So
to become a saint.
He also had fallen in love with, I don't know, is it the king's daughter or correct. Wife or
king's
whatnot.
Daughter, yep.
And,
the emperor's daughter.
And he was jailed and he was sentenced to death. And he wrote a note basically on his deathbed to that woman. And he signed it, My Valentine. So that's where this all comes from.
The genesis of the Valentine's Day.
Yeah, yeah. Unless you Google it and read it, you would never imagine that this holiday started that way.
With tragedy.
And then Hallmark took over.
Yes.
You know, I like Hallmark. I like their cringy
mm-hmm.
Christmas movies.
Mm-hmm.
They're the best.
you know,
the year-round cringy Christmas
yes,
movies?
I will do it, absolutely. I'm like, I'm in the mood for something that cheers me up.
You know, some of the channels are still showing those Christmas movies.
There's a Hallmark movie channel year-round.
Yeah.
Did you see about Suits? Like, you know the show Suits?
I'm familiar with it, but I haven't watched it.
Okay, so apparently they're making it like a new one, but it's going to be Suits LA.
Mm-hmm.
And it's with the dude from Arrow, Stephen Amell. I don't even know. But it was announced yesterday. And not a lot of people like him, like what he did during the strike. But you know.
Do we have the next TMZ host here or something?
She's trying out her format.
Yeah.
For next year.
Mm-hmm. All right. So something that we do every year is we go over... some of the new candy conversation hearts that are available.
Oh, great.
Yeah, so feel free to give your opinion on some of these. We got a slide of 14, 15 of them maybe. So let's see what we came up with this year.
Hold on. I want to be able to see her reaction, so I'm going to put it in the bottom screen.
Okay. All right, and... There's something I have queued underneath that line on that paper.
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
Okay. Okay, here we go. All right. Valentine's Day 2024 Conversation Hearts. You cannot get these at the store. You can't get these down the door. You can only find these here on the den, Ken's den.
So this your first one, Drop Dead?
Drop Dead.
I think it's nice.
Yeah?
Oh, she's like, Drop Dead. She's like, oh my gosh, she's Drop Dead beautiful.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Don't think it's quite that way.
Yeah, didn't mean it that way, but we'll go with that.
She's always looking on the brighter side of life. Yeah.
Next.
Shake it up. Shake it up.
I threw you one, okay? But it can really be just shake it off.
You've just been dumped.
Oh.
Yeah, shake it off.
But then they'll listen to 1989 Taylor.
I knew she was immediately going to turn into a Swiftie when she saw that one.
I have my shirt on today.
What's it say?
Sophia's version on it.
Oh, okay.
Because
what does that mean?
It's another meaning because when she puts out her other ones, it's Taylor's version.
Oh, okay.
Sophia's version because it's TV, but mine's SV.
I'm so disconnected with pop culture right now, Pete.
Yep. We say,
just know.
Oh, maybe they got proposed and then they just like,
Mm-hmm.
They said no.
She's starting to get it.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Wow. Try a mint.
That is really, really
mean. And in itself, it could be a mint too.
No.
The heart.
No. Because that's strawberry, I think. Because the one that's like semi-mint is mint.
Peppermint can be pink.
No, but it's the strawberry. There's a difference between peppermint and strawberry.
They can both be pink, though.
No. Mm. They can't.
After you just gone out to that dinner of chicken piccata?
Yeah.
Try a mint.
I had the garlic enchilada with onion chafer.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sure. Mm-hmm.
Before you kiss me goodnight on Valentine's Day,
yeah.
Try a mint.
Mm-hmm. Not yours.
Not your teddy bear.
Okay, that's a riff on the cart that usually says, I'm yours.
I know.
Oh, okay. So, I knew she'd look for the positive side of all of these. And she was doing a pretty good job, I'd say, by the way.
Yeah, that's her role.
Yeah, that's exactly why she's here.
I have a very important...
All right. How are you going to handle this one? Go away.
Well, go away is either... Like, they woke up together, and he's, like, kissing her, and she's like, go away, and you have, like, morning breath.
Oh, well, then you would go back one, and you'd have a mint.
No, because she's, like, she just wants to sleep in.
Well, the mint would take care of that morning breath you mentioned.
Yeah, but also she's trying to sleep in.
Yeah. All right. How do you know about stuff like that?
I read a lot of romantic...
Oh, okay. I hope that's okay.
I have a full bookshelf of them.
All right.
Organized by popularity, in author, in color.
Wow.
Here's what you tell people, Sophia?
Pound sand.
I have no clue what this is.
You don't know what pound sand means?
No.
It's an expression. Go pound sand.
Mm-hmm. Pound sand.
Kind of like the aggressive version of go away.
Pound sand is like you're doing something over and over and over. They want this folder.
Oh.
I'm 53 years old, and I can still lip-read teenage girls from across the room.
There you go.
Yeah. Yeah, so pound sand.
You're pounding the sand at the beach.
Yeah,
no. It's
the more aggressive form of go away.
Yeah, it's like, take a walk east until your hat floats.
But it's like maybe it's like in the movies when they have their third breakup scene. They're like, go away, I don't need you. Like, it's like the, from Notting Hill when she's like, I'm just a girl who just wants to be loved. And then she turns away. And then.
Yeah. I thought she was starting to get this.
Yeah, I guess not.
Yeah. Hard pass.
Oh.
That's now level 3 of where we started.
Oh, level
3. Yeah.
Maybe hard pass.
Yeah, hard pass is a big no.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you ever said that to a guy?
No.
Hard pass?
No, I would say that to my coach. Like, if we have a set, I'm like, I did not sign up for this.
That's a hard pass
for
me.
Okay, good. Yes, all right. Yeah, she got that one. You know, it's like me asking a young lady, I go, would you like to go out for lunch? And she turns around and says, hard pass.
I'm so sorry for you, Kenny.
Oh, don't feel bad. I've stopped asking a long time ago.
I'm being sarcastic.
Of course you were.
Well, that's level 4.
Yep.
There's a song called I Hate You, I Love You. Mm-hmm. There's a trope called enemies to lovers, and first ready, they can hate each other, and then they can fall in love with each other.
Uh-huh. All right, we obviously know what that's the replacement for. You know, one of the songs I was going to pick for today was I Hate Everything About You, and then I started listening to the lyrics, and I couldn't play it. Matter of fact, half of the anti-Valentine's Day type songs I couldn't play on this program. Yeah, Added Up by Violent Femmes was one of them. I'm like, oh, no way can I play that.
Then this goes to level 5 if you don't get those previous 4 hints.
Do people still do that?
Sometimes. It's not, right. It's not commonly used anymore.
Loser.
They just go.
And you know, I think there's a song called Loser. I think there might be more than one.
There's a few, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, next.
Really? Really? Not so swift?
Yeah, that's a real saying. And has nothing to do with Swift.
Okay, making sure.
All right.
We'll have problems with that.
It's like you do something and you fail, or you break it, or you mess it up. Ooh, you're told, you know what? That wasn't very swift of you.
You should watch Crazy Rich Asians.
Mm-hmm.
How do you watch that much TV with all the stuff you do?
It's called increments of time.
Oh, okay.
You know,
you're one of the busiest people I know.
No, because ready? On my regular season, it's home. Well, wake up at home. Watch TV, eat breakfast, get dressed, go to school. Then after that, go back home, relax, have dinner, go to swim, then go to bed, have a shower and all that stuff.
She just made me want to take a nap.
I know. She's one of the busiest people I know.
Mm-hmm.
I have swim this week and Saturday.
And finally, not a chance. That comes back to me asking a nice young lady if she wants to go to lunch. Pound sand, hard pass. Not a chance.
They're just rejecting, you know that, right?
Mm-hmm. And if you don't get that, the hint on not a chance, it gets followed up by get lost.
Get lost.
I'm so sorry, Kenny. Your romantic life is just not great. You need to put your Tinder or Hinge.
We've had that disclaimer over and over and over.
I'm sorry, but we have to put you in Hinge or Tinder.
You know what? I know what that means, and people will look at me and instead of swiping left, they'll swipe right.
No, because
that would make a great heart, Pete. Swipe right.
Did you have that 1 year?
Yeah, I did. I think I had that 2 years ago. Swipe right.
I do remember that.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, go get those 2 dating apps, and then you never know.
There's a lot of catfishing going on in
them things. I know. And there's a Netflix special about that too.
You really want Kenny to find love, don't you?
He deserves love. Even though he's a tiny bit annoying.
Love that.
You see why she is replacing Kathy today?
Yes.
Yeah. All right. Getting ready to wrap up. What do you tend to do for Valentine's Day? Anything special?
Well, usually I go out to dinner with my dad after swim.
Mm-hmm.
And then I go to bed.
Uh-huh. You going to go to Village?
I don't think so.
Uh-huh.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe.
Uh-huh.
I don't
see now. I've put that idea in your head.
I know. Or either you'll make me a really good soup.
Mm-hmm.
Because now I'm in the mood for soup.
You know, today is a soup day. It's under 30 degrees.
I have a salad today because I always eat salad.
Mm-hmm.
Every day.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know.
Just because?
Because she's making it known that she's healthier than all of us.
Well, that's probably true.
Yeah.
I swim for 5 days a week, 2 hours a day, and then in regular season, 6 days a week. Half.
I'm going to go home, have a cheeseburger and 2 yodels.
And then I'm going to start this year. Me and my dad are going to train to mount, bike Mount Greylock.
Holy cow.
Wow.
Yeah. Because I already did the notch, and I want to do it.
God bless the enthusiasm you have. I mean,
don't
that
worry.
Is...
I've done crazier things.
Well, your dad's an athlete, too, so...
Yeah.
All right, I get it.
Don't worry. I've done crazier things. I've ziplined underneath a gorge in the forests of Costa Rica. Mm-hmm. And also rock climb in
rafting.
in the rivers,
uh-huh,
and surf in Costa Rica.
And that's why, you know, I had no question with who to bring on here this morning, because if she can handle all that, she can handle Kenny here on the den.
It's true.
Yeah, and I think we already covered what you're going to do for Valentine's Day.
Yep.
Yep. And
I have swim too, so.
And
it's taper week.
Yeah, I think I have a Walmart delivery this afternoon.
Ooh.
And as I said, I think I'm probably going to have a cheeseburger and some yodels. And you know what? I haven't gotten that far as dinner yet. Maybe I will order a heart-shaped pizza.
I have a dinner really early. It's kind of sad. Mm-hmm. Well, during my regular season, it's like at 4.
Uh-huh.
But usually now my dinner is at like 6, because I get out early and swim this week.
Mm-hmm.
Like 5:30. No, I get out at 5:30. We stay in the hot showers in the locker room for like 15 minutes.
You know, and eventually it'll all come back and turn around to that, because 10 years from now, dinner will be 7, 8 o'clock. But then 50 years down the road, you're in a nursing home and dinner's back at 4:30. So
don't call me old already. I'm already old.
You're not even close.
I am. You can't see, but I have white gray hairs in my hairline already. Mm-hmm.
You know, I can see them. You're going to have to get some Clairol or something.
I don't want to dye my hair.
No?
No.
All right.
It's just the it's the chemicals, and it's like the coloration. And
oh, all the chlorine and stuff might not be helping you, too.
Well, I've been swimming for almost a decade, so I can't stop swimming.
Oh, that'll mess up the pigment. Pigmentation.
Yeah, no, because the pigment in your hair is losing, like, the colors in mm-hmm. your hair. Mm-hmm. So that's why they keep, like...
Well, hair is naturally white.
It is naturally white.
Yeah. Yeah. And a lot of us get there closer than others. All right. Well, that is it for our Valentine's Day special. Sophia, I want to thank you for coming in here and giving us 20 minutes of your life that you're never going to get back.
It's okay. I can go back to class, you know. Mm-hmm. I have some Canva stuff to do for my swim team, because my dad took some really good photos of our team on Sunday.
Mm-hmm. Very cool.
Yeah, awesome. And I'm kind of frustrated with Canva right now because it's currently glitching and I don't like it.
Well, we want to wish you good luck at States.
Thank you. Oh, there'll probably be a big article.
Cool.
All right. Happy Valentine's Day.
Bye, everyone.
If you care.
Bye, Kenny. Thanks for having me.
Love stinks. Love.